Hello everyone, this is our revision video and in this video I will make you explain all the try this so that every topic can be clear based on related angles. Means we have to tell here which pair of the following given angles are complementary. Suppose this is given to you on the, see on the page number 95 of your book, this is given and we have to tell here that angles are complementary or not. For this I told you what are the complementary angles whose sum is 90 degree. Now when we will do the sum, 70 plus 20 90 degree, so you will write yes, this is the pair, these angles are complementary. Yes, these are complementary angles. This way more parts are given. Suppose next part, second part is given to you here, this is given 75 and next angle is given to you 25. Here sum is 100 degree, so you will write no, not complementary. These angles are not complementary because their sum is not 90 degree, not complementary. This way you will do the rest two parts also. Now come to question number 2. What is the measure of complement? Next question is given to you. What is the complement of? Now parts are given to you. First part is given to you 45. I told you two angles are complementary when their sum is 90 degree. We don't know its complement. Let the complement be x. Let the complement be x degree. Now this and the complement both will make 90 degree. Two angles, when sum of two angles is 90 degree, they both are complementary. And so x will be equal to 90 minus 45, x is equal to 45. Otherwise you can directly write the complement means 90 minus the angle given to you. Directly also, if one word, it will come in one word, you will write directly 90 minus given angle. Again you will get 45. Suppose second part is given to you 65 and it is coming in one word, directly subtract 90 minus 65 and write down here complement. Complement. Complement of 65 is, now subtract it, you will get 25. So this is the complement. Suppose these are two angles, 65 is the complement of 25 and 25 is the complement of 65. This way you will do question number 2, next part also. Now come to third question. Third question is, the difference in the measure of two complementary angles is 12 degree. Find the angles. Means we don't know both the angles. So first of all you will write down, let one angle, one of the angle A be x degree. Aur iska complement ho jayega. Complement, how we are finding out the complement? 90 minus x degree. This is the complement. Because when you will add these two, you will get 90. Then we are finding out the complement, 90 minus given angle. Now angle is x, so 90 minus x is the complement. Now in the question, according to the question, A, T, Q means according to question. Question mein kya given hai? Difference in the measure of two complementary angle is 12. Means in dono ka difference. How do we find out the difference? This number minus 90 minus x. Subtract first number minus second number. This is the difference. And this is given to you 12 degree. Difference is given to you 12 degree. Now solve this equation. X. Now before bracket minus sign is given. So inside sign will change. 90 is given positive. It will become negative. If this is given negative, it will become positive and will be equal to 12. Now x is positive and this x is positive, 2x, and minus 90 will transpose. We will transpose this minus 90 to that side, means after the equal to side, right side of equal to, it will become positive because it is here negative. When we will transport, sign will change. Now 2x will be equal to 102. Now x will be equal to 102 divided by 2 is multiplied here, 2 will divide that side. It will become 51. Now this is the angle, first angle, and its complement. How do we find out the complement? Angle is 51 and complement will be equal to 90 minus 51. What will come? 39. So how do we verify it? When you will add these two, you will get 90 degree. This is the verification. इससे पता चल जाएगा कि आप करेक्ट हैं. Come to page number 96. Try these. In this try these, question is given to you. Find the pair of supplementary angles. Figures are given to you. I have drawn first part 110 and 50. Now the pair of angles is said to be supplementary if their sum is 180 degree. Now see their sum, 110 plus 50, it will become 160. So the pair is not supplementary. So you will write here not supplementary angles. No, these angles are not supplementary. This way you will do all the parts. Whenever we have to tell, you will just add them, and if the result will come 180, you will write yes, otherwise write down no. Now second question is, what will be the measure of supplement? Means we have to find out the measure of supplement. Like in complement, I told you, you have to do 90 minus the given angle. This way, here you have to, the given angle is 100 degree, and you have to find out the supplement. If in one word it will come, you will subtract it from 180. 180 minus 100. You will get 80 degree. 80 degree is the supplement of 100 degree. Now 100 and 80 are supplement of each other. 100 is supplement of 80 and 80 is supplement of 100 because their sum is 180. This way you will do next three parts also. And remember one more thing. You have to always do the try these in CW copy. Don't do try these in homework copy. It is understood. Come to page 97 and question number 3. Among two supplementary angles, the measure of larger angle is 44 degree more than measure of smaller. Find their measures. Means we have to find out both the angles. Smaller as well as larger, and both are supplementary. It means sum of both the angles is 180 degree. We have to find out both the angles and we don't know both. So let the smaller angle be x degree and larger angle be x plus 44, because it is written in the question measure of larger angle is 44 more than smaller say 44 more, so that's why I have written x plus 44. Now according to question, these are given supplementary, means sum of these two angles is equal to 180. Sum of both angles will be equal to 180 according to question, because both are given supplementary. When you will do the sum, x and x will become 2x, and this 44, it will go, we will transpose this 44, it, this is given in positive, and when we will transpose this to the right side, it will become negative. So 2x will be equal to 136 and x will be equal to 136 divided by 2. 2 is multiplied here, it will become divide, and it you will get 68. Now 68 x is equal to 68 means smaller angle is equal to 68. So smaller angle will be equal to 68 and larger, we have to tell both. So larger is x plus 48, 68 plus 48. Do 68 plus 44, you will get 112 degree. Now for verification, you can add these two. Its sum must be 180 degree. Now let us revise adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? You people are facing difficulty because these are the new topics of this session. So what are adjacent angles? Two angles are said to be adjacent if they have common vertex. Means if there are two angles and they both are having same vertex, they are said to be adjacent. But three conditions must be applied. First thing, vertex must be common. Second thing, one common arm must be there. Suppose this is the arm OABC. When you will draw angle 1, OB arm will come. And when you will draw angle 2, in angle 2 also OB arm is there. So OB arm is common here. So common arm must be there, common vertex must be there. And third thing, non-common arms are on the either side of common arm. This is the common arm and these two are non-common. Non-common means jo angle 1 mein arm hai wo angle 2 mein nahi hai. OC is not in angle 2. So this is non-common. Ye common nahi hai. Common wo hoti hai jo dono mein ho. OB is common because OB lie between two. OB angle 1 banane mein bhi OB ka use hua hai and angle 2 बनाने में भी OB का use हुआ है. OC is non-common because OC angle 1 में ही use हो रही है, 2 में नहीं. Same way OA, OA is used in only angle 2, angle 1 में use नहीं हो रही. So these two lines are said to be, these two rays are said to be non-common arms. ये वाली भी non-common है and ये वाली भी non-common arms है. तो non-common arms common arm के अलग अलग साइड पर होनी चाहिए. दिस इज द मीनिंग कि नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स कॉमन आर्म के डिफरेंट साइड पे होना चाहिए. अगर ये तीनों कंडीशन अप्लाइड हैं देन द एंगल्स आर एडजेसेंट एंगल्स. सो डू द ट्राई दिस बेस्ड ऑन इन दिस. नाउ वी हैव टू टेल हेयर वेदर दीज एंगल्स आर एडजेसेंट और नॉट. सो सी हेयर, वर्टेक्स इज कॉमन, दिस आर्म इज कॉमन. This arm is in angle 1 also, angle 2 also used. This middle arm, this is common arm. And these are non-common, ye bhi non-common hai. Non-common arms are on the either side of common arm. So these two angles are said to be adjacent. So you will write here, yes, adjacent angles. So second part is given to you here. This also, in this part also, common vertex is same. कॉमन रे, ये एंगल 1 में भी है, 2 में भी है ये रे. तो कॉमन आर्म भी है, कॉमन वर्टेक्स भी है एंड ये नॉन कॉमन आर्म है, ये भी नॉन कॉमन आर्म है. नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स आर ऑन द अपोजिट साइड ऑफ कॉमन आर्म. सो दीज एंगल्स आर एडजेसेंट. नाउ थर्ड पार्ट, सी हेयर, वर्टेक्स ऑफ एंगल 1 इज हेयर, वर्टेक्स ऑफ एंगल 2 इज हेयर. वर्टेक्स इज नॉट कॉमन, पहला पॉइंट ही अप्लाई नहीं हो पा रहा. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट डज नॉट होल्ड, तो आप क्या कहेंगे, एडजेसेंट दिस इज नॉट द पेयर ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स. सी द फोर्थ पार्ट गिवन ऑन पेज 98. नाउ दिस इज गिवन ऑन पेज 98. वी हैव टू टेल हियर वेदर द पेयर ऑफ एंगल्स इज एडजेसेंट और नॉट. सी हेयर, दिस इज एंगल 1, एंगल 1 इज दिस मच ओनली. And this is angle 2. Angle 2 कितना है, यहाँ से यहाँ तक. This one means this one. When we have made angle 1, this arm we have used and this used. And when we have made angle 2, angle 2 बनाया, this arm is common. ये आम दोनों में यूज हुई, एंगल वन के अंदर भी, ये एंगल वन बनाया तो ये दोनों आम है, दिस वन एंड दिस, और एंगल टू व्हेन वी आर मेकिंग एंगल टू, दिस आम एंड दिस आम अगेन. सो विच आम इज कॉमन? दिस आम. दिस इज द कॉमन आर्म एंड दिस इज नॉन कॉमन. दिस इज नॉन कॉमन. ये आम एंगल वन में यूज हो रही है, एंगल टू में नहीं हो रही, और ये आम एंगल टू में यूज हो रही है, एंगल वन में नहीं हो रही. सो दीज टू आर्म्स आर नॉन कॉमन एंड नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स आर. अब नाउ अब देखिए कि वर्टेक्स इज सेम, वर्टेक्स इज कॉमन, वन आर्म इज कॉमन, बट थर्ड कंडीशन, इन द थर्ड कंडीशन इट वॉज गिवन दैट नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स मस्ट बी ऑन द ईदर साइड ऑफ कॉमन, बट हेयर बोथ आर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ कॉमन आर्म. दोनों नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स कॉमन आर्म के एक ही साइड पर हैं. सो वी विल से हेयर नो दीज आर नॉट एडजेसेंट एंगल्स. ये एडजेसेंट एंगल्स नहीं हैं. नाउ कम टू लीनियर पेयर. अ लीनियर पेयर इज अ पेयर ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स, मीन्स एंगल मस्ट बी एडजेसेंट. हुज नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स, ये हैं इसकी नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स. नॉन कॉमन आर्म्स आर अपोजिट रेज. नाउ दीज आर नॉट अपोजिट, अपोजिट आर दीज. सो यू हैव टू राइट डाउन पेयर ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स एंड एंगल्स मस्ट बी सप्लीमेंट्री. हेयर एंगल्स आर नॉट सप्लीमेंट्री. एंगल्स आर नॉट मेकिंग 180 डिग्री. हेयर एंगल्स आर मेकिंग 180 डिग्री. सो लीनियर पेयर इज अ पेयर ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स हुज एंगल्स आर सप्लीमेंट्री. दिस इज टू, दीज टू कंडीशन मस्ट अप्लाई. एडजेसेंट भी होने चाहिए प्लस देयर सम मस्ट बी 180 और दे विल बी 180 डिग्री. सो यू रिमेंबर दीज टू थिंग्स, देन ओनली द पेयर विल बी लीनियर. नाउ एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन ऑन, ट्राई दिस, गिवन ऑन पेज 99. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट, चेक whether the pair of angles form a linear pair or not. One angle is given to you 140 degree and other is given to you 40 degree. So you write down, yes, this is the pair of, we have to write here, yes, this is the pair of linear pair, pair of angle form a linear pair. And then in the second part, you see in the book 60 and 60 degree is given to you. You will write no, because both are not making supplementary. 90 and 80, third part, you will write down no, because their sum is not supplementary. So you have to check down, check their angles must be supplementary also. Page 101, try this, given here, based on vertically opposite angles, when two lines intersect each other and cut out at one point, they are said to be intersecting lines, and these two angles are angles opposite to same vertex, common vertex, point of intersection are said to be vertically opposite angle. Here 1 and 3 are vertically opposite angles. Here in this question, angle 1 is given to you 30 degree. We have to find out angle 2 and 3. How do we find out 3? 3 and 1 are opposite angles, vertically opposite angle. You write down angle 3 equal to angle 1, vertically opposite angles. So angle 3 will be equal to 30 degree. We have put the value of 1 here. Now we have to find out angle 2 also. So see here, 1 and 2 both are adjacent and both are making straight line, means supplementary. So you write down here angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degree. दोनों का सम 180 है, because they are making a straight line. तो आप इसका reason लिखोगे linear pair. They are linear pair because they are adjacent as well as making straight line. So they are linear pair. Some students are thinking, if three angles are given to you on single line, they are writing linear pair. Let me tell you, don't write linear pair, because here how many angles given on the line? 1, 2 and 3. When 3 angles, 3 or 4 angles are given on line, you will not write linear pair. Pair means 2 angles. Now here only 2 angles, that's why I am writing linear pair. If 3 angles will come, you will write down the reason. Suppose this is x, this is x plus 20, this is x plus 10. Then you will write x plus 20, x plus 10, sum of these three equal to 180. And the reason you will write down angles on a straight line. This mistake most of the students are doing. That's why I am telling you. Now in the linear pair, only two angles must be there. Pair means two. So here value of 1 is 30 degree plus angle 2 equal to 180. Angle 2 will be equal to 180 minus 30. Angle 2 will be equal to 150. These two angles we have to find out. Come to page number 106. And it is given here, name the pairs of angle in each figure. Figures are given to you. See, in the first figure, these two angles, we have to give the name. What is the name of this pair? This is corresponding angles pair, because they both are having different vertices. They both are on the same side of transversal, and both are in corresponding position. Corresponding position means both are above the line. दोनों अबव द लाइन है या दोनों बिलो द लाइन होते या दोनों सेम साइड ऑफ ट्रांसवर्सल होने चाहिए. करस्पोंडिंग पोजिशन होनी चाहिए, सेम डिफरेंट वर्टेक्स होना चाहिए. वर्टेक्स मस्ट बी डिफरेंट एंड साइड मस्ट बी सेम. एंड थर्ड थिंग, पोजिशन मस्ट बी करस्पोंडिंग. मीन्स दिस इज अबव द लाइन, दिस इज अबव द लाइन, सो दीज आर करस्पोंडिंग पेयर. एंड दिस वन इज, सेकेंड वन इज दिस. दिस इज ट्रांसवर्सल, और जो इंटीरियर में हो, ये दो लाइन्स हैं, दो लाइन के इंटीरियर में है ये, और ये इफ दे आर ऑन द अपोजिट साइड ऑफ ट्रांसवर्सल और लाई बिटवीन द टू लाइन्स एंड हैव डिफरेंट वर्टिसेस. तीन कंडीशन पूरी होनी चाहिए अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स के लिए. सो दीज आर अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स जो कि ट्रांसवर्सल के अपोजिट साइड हों, इंटीरियर में हों, और थर्ड थिंग उनका वर्टेक्स भी डिफरेंट होना चाहिए. नाउ कम टू दिस फिगर, थर्ड वन. इन दिस फिगर बोथ द एंगल्स आर बिटवीन द टू लाइन्स एंड बोथ आर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ ट्रांसवर्सल, सो यू कैन से को इंटीरियर एंगल. इधर यू विल राइट डाउन को इंटीरियर, और यू कैन से इंटीरियर एंगल्स ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ ट्रांसवर्सल. एंड दीज आर अल्टरनेट, दीज आर करस्पोंडिंग. एंड नाउ कम हेयर, दीज आर अगेन करस्पोंडिंग. ये ट्रांसवर्सल है, ट्रांसवर्सल के सेम साइड पर हैं, वर्टेक्स डिफरेंट हैं, करस्पोंडिंग पोजिशन है, मीन्स दोनों ही लाइन के अबव है, ये भी लाइन के अबव है. सो दीज आर करस्पोंडिंग पेयर. सो कम टू दिस नाउ, 9 and 10. दिस इज पेयर ऑफ अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर. ट्रांसवर्सल के अपोजिट साइड पर, वर्टेक्स डिफरेंट, बोथ आर इन द इंटीरियर, सो दे आर अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर. Now come to this part, 11 and 12. These are linear pair, adjacent bhi hain, and both are making straight line. So both are making linear pair. Come to page 109. Try this given here. Here these two lines are given to you parallel. This transversal is given to you. This angle is given to you 60. This is x. Given here L is parallel to M and we have to find out the value of X. Now see here, when two lines are parallel, this is the rule that when two lines are parallel, alternate interior angles are always equal. ये मैंने आपको previous video में बताया था. तो X will be equal to 60 degree, और reason जरूर लिखना है. Reason is alternate interior angles, write in the bracket using pencil. And you have to do all these sums in your CW copy. Rest of the parts, if I am not doing here, you have to do all the parts. Some parts I am explaining you, and rest of the parts you will do yourself. And children, after completing the chapter, you have to submit your notebooks also. Now see, second part. Here also is A and B parallel lines given to you. This line C is transversal. Now again transversal के opposite side पर हैं और interior में है, it means they are alternate interior angles. So y is equal to 55 will come, and reason in the bracket you will write same way, alternate interior angles. When lines are parallel, alternate interior angles are always equal. In the third part, L1 and L2 are two lines given to you. And they are asking you, is angle 1 equal to angle 2? You will write here no, because L1 and L2 are not parallel. Here it is not given. L1 and L2 parallel nahi hai, toh it means alternate interior angles bhi equal nahi hai. So you will write down no. Iski place par aap likhoge no, not equal, because lines are not parallel. Reason always you have to write down. Here P line, L and M given to you, parallel lines. These two lines are parallel and these two are also given to you parallel. Now whenever I have to find out A, I will require P and Q parallel. You write down P and Q are parallel lines. L is transversal. When we have to find out angle A, L transversal ka use hoga yahan pe. L is, L act as transversal. Ye dono line parallel. Then ye dono angles kaise ho gaye? Co-interior angles. And co-interior angles, jab lines parallel ho, to co-interior ka sum 180 hota. So you will write down 60 plus A is equal to 180. Aur reason hai co-interior angles, because when lines are parallel, co-interior angles are supplementary. So the result is A is equal to 120 degree. First thing. Second thing, B nikalna hai. Mujhe B nikalne ke liye mujhe isko nikalna padega. First I will write down here with pencil in the figure 1. Now A and 1 both are making linear pair. तो आप इसमें लिखोगे A and 1 आर मेकिंग लीनियर पेयर. सो राइट डाउन एंगल A प्लस एंगल 1 इक्वल टू 180. रीजन है लीनियर पेयर एंड वन A जस्ट नाउ वी हैव फाइंड आउट 120. सो 1 विल बी इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री. अदरवाइज आप लीनियर पेयर से नहीं भी निकाल रहे तो ये दो लाइन पैरेलल है तो अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स इक्वल है. सो 1 इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री डायरेक्ट भी लिख सकते हो. 1 इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री ब्रैकेट में लिख दोगे अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स. नाउ 1 एंड बी आर करस्पोंडिंग. व्हेन दीज टू लाइन्स आर पैरेलल मीन्स व्हेन एल इज पैरेलल टू, व्हेन एल इज पैरेलल टू एम एंड क्यू इज ट्रांसवर्सल. क्यू जब ट्रांसवर्सल है तो 1 एंड बी आर करस्पोंडिंग एंगल्स. सो हमें बी निकालना है तो वी विल राइट बी ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड. बी इक्वल टू एंगल 1 बिकॉज बोथ आर करस्पोंडिंग एंगल्स एंड बी इज सॉरी 1 एंगल 1 इज 60 डिग्री. सो बी विल बी इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री. नाउ बी एंड सी आर वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स. सो आप सी निकालना है तो सी को लेफ्ट साइड पे लिखोगे सी इक्वल टू बी वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स सी इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री. नाउ आफ्टर सी वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट डी. बोथ आर मेकिंग लीनियर पेयर. देन यू विल राइट डाउन सी प्लस एंगल सी प्लस एंगल डी इक्वल टू 180. इन द ब्रैकेट राइट डाउन लीनियर पेयर. एंगल सी इज 60 प्लस डी इक्वल टू 180. डी विल बी इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 60. डी विल बी इक्वल टू 120 डिग्री. नाउ वी हैव फाइंड आउट ऑल द एंगल्स. दिस वे यू विल डू दिस सम एंड पेज 110 ट्राई. दीज आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. यू कैन सी नाउ दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट दिस चैप्टर. We have done revision also, and now you have to submit your notebooks after completing the chapter as soon as possible. Thank you very much.